Hello, I'm Dr. Deb, and I'm the department chair and instructor for the Learning Strategies Department here at VC. In today's video, I'm explaining how you can use spaced practice to improve your learning and studying. VC's Total Learning Center presents, Dr. Deb Explains, Spaced Practice. Have you ever spent hours the day before an important exam desperately cramming material into your brain? I'm sure most of us have done that at one time or another. Unfortunately, though, it doesn't always work. And, as we know from the information processing theory, it doesn't work for long-term memory and retrieval. You may be able to recall some of the information based on sheer repetition, but you won't be able to recall and utilize that information in the distant future. In order to learn the material most effectively, it is better to use the learning strategy of spaced practice. This simply means that you space your practice out over several days in smaller increments. So if you would normally set aside 8 hours before an exam to cram the information into your brain, you may break those 8 hour segments into 16 30-minute study sessions and start 2 weeks before the exam. Or if you follow the study cycle, you would begin studying and learning the material the same day the professor presents it. The best way to use spaced practice is to review the material as soon as the class or lecture ends. And it doesn't have to be hours. Just set aside 20 to 30 minutes to review the main ideas. Then set aside 20 to 30 minutes to review and retrieve that same information the next day. If you do this every day with the new content that you receive and continue to review the content in the unit, then when the exam arrives, you don't really have to study because you've been studying every day since the lectures began. And there's definitely no need for cramming. As you can see, spaced practice works really well when combined with retrieval practice. That's the ideal scenario, but it doesn't have to happen this way. You could simply review and learn the day's content in 20 to 30 minutes, and then review and learn the new content when it arrives. The only key item that you want to remember is that multiple shorter sessions are better for your brain and learning than a single long session. This is supported by what we know about the information processing theory and cognitive load theory. Leave a comment below and tell me what you think about this concept and how it can help you learn. If you want to know more about how to be a successful college student based on the theories, strategies, and principles for student success, click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell, and check out my other videos as Dr. Deb Explains.